For the last several days, archaeologists have continued mapping and excavating the site. The more delicate items have been recovered and brought to the surface, including a salt shaker, buttons, a collection of plates, and even pieces of a pocket watch. Last night's retrieval of the large artifact recovery box and the small artifacts inside it was met with awe and silence by the entire crew. These artifacts, in many ways, were more fragile than the first batch of bottles and ceramics. Once the artifacts were examined and placed into wet storage for the night, the crew began preparations for lifting the ship's cannon. The crew's preparation and efforts met with success in the pre-dawn hours on Friday when the cannon was rigged with two lifting straps, connected to the ship's winch, and hoisted to the surface. For the first time since the Mardi Gras vessel sank, its cannon was on the surface of a ship's deck. The cannon's original iron construction has now degraded to the point that only the biological and iron concretions on its exterior held it together for the lift. Even the biologist on the mission managed to examine some of the deep water biological organisms that made their home on the cannon. The cannon now awaits transport and conservation at Texas A&M as the crew prepares to lift the ship's cast iron stove to the surface.